I seem to specialize in them.
I understand that Morozov has a Nazi escort and that you need support, but tricking the Russian Air Force? It's suicide.
I just need them to follow me, Tommy. Once they meet the Germans, they'll forget about little Didi, and Morozov will be mine. That I want.
Thank you.
Black Wing? Did I inherit a code name? Murdered the man who made me a murderer.
I've been talking to Night Owl. She has some ideas of what we might do next, I mean.
I'm sure she does. Drunk at that moment. My head span and my teeth ached as I ground them together. The world became a dull roar. All that existed was Morozov's plane perfectly framed in my sights. I felt a brief moment of satisfaction as he fell from the sky. Smoke curled from his plane, flames licking hungrily around its engine. I spitefully hoped that he was still alive to feel the terror of that moment. I like to think that I wasn't myself. To kill in war is not murder, but Morozov had made me a murderer. All those innocents in the factory I bombed, it was unforgivable. And my vengeance against Morozov didn't wash clean my sins. It was yet more blood on my hands. I had learned that money cannot pay for everything.
What's the deal with you and the girl? You're not related, are you?
Oh no, I flew with her father in the Great War. We got close after taking it. I was never fond of children. But somehow protecting people was even harder. With every mistake I made, it felt as though I was executing some brave Anzac soldier who was relying on his air cover as much as his own squad. It was vital to lose no more than 2/5 of the Anzac forces. That was the instruction on the brass. So those of us in the sky shot each other down until the operation was deemed a success or a failure. I didn't see much of Guillaume de Bec this time out. Not until after the battle, when he caught up with me in the hospital.
Hospital? You were down?
That's right. Cape Helen, where I joined the Survivors Club. I think that's why Guillaume approached me, as much as anything. All his friends were dead, and he was all alone.
Thank you.
Sneaked in a cigar and a hip glass of whiskey that we shared. And he gave me a crumpled picture of a baby girl with a scrawled address upon the back. More than one of those pictures, I'm sure. I don't think he imagined he'd live for long. He fell out of the sky too often. All the people who get the pictures from us, I'm the one who found the trail. Your old man.
Clearly aren't expecting any aerial resistance. I shall be pleased to make their acquaintance.
I'm trying to contact the ground forces. I think it's the Chetniks.
Tell them not to shoot me. Concerned with anyone manning an AK who might mistake me for a Nazi, Thomas. Talk to that man specifically. Incoming! More of the same, Tommy.
Nadini. Name of Kostich, I think.
Is he on the ground beneath me?
We have a camp nearby. Don't know where. Keep it up, Didi.
Stiff up a lip, Thomas. There's more? How many Luftwaffe can there be in Yugoslavia?
Just stay alive. Kostich says we can meet with him. But you'd better make sure the bridge is safe. They're awfully protective of it.
Well, it is a lovely bridge. The Hun's nose, as McIntyre would say. The Nazis don't own the Yugoslavian skies anymore. Something. It's begun.
Thank you.
armed forces approaching the installation, but anti-tank barriers are slowing them. Anything you can do?
I'll give it a try. About lives.
We've had reports of German tanks. They've got to be destroyed.
I have to find them first. They must be well camouflaged.
We'll have to hunt them out.
For the resistance and their charming guardian angel. Wait, Tommy, I'm seeing things. Our bloody allies. They're murdering the locals, Tommy. They're killing the civilians.
What should we do?
We'll bloody well stop them, is what we shall do.
Don't kill them, just scare them off.
Two birds with one stone? Run the Nazis out of Yugoslavia and kill their traditional enemies at the same time?
The war, Didi. It's eating everyone alive.
Not me. Not without a fight. We should talk to Night Owl.
Thank you.
I'm bored.
Bored or not, your boy does look rough, that is right. I should get back on the ground. Let's land at the camp, boss.
Your arrival is timely, Blackwing. Our boys need weapons. We must destroy them.
Load everything you've got. I'll parachute supplies to the ground. I've still half a tank of fuel. Clive, you stay here.
Sure thing, boss. You mustn't land.
Thank you.
walk straight.
Easy, Tommy. I'll bail him out. Again. There were too many for you to take on yourself, Clive?
One's too many. Oh, me poor Shayla. I'll have to patch up all these bullet holes.
You gave your plane a name? Ugh, men. Nazi bastards!
You're wrong. Marshal Tito ordered the bridge destroyed as a gambit. It is a ruse. Yugoslavia is overrun. Marshal Tito has 20,000 men pinned by 150,000 Germans. They have many wounded soldiers.
The Germans were expecting us to cross the Neretva Bridge. If they see it destroyed, however, they will mobilize in the north.
By the time they realize that the Yugoslavs haven't moved, the bridge will be rebuilt and crossed.
What? He's insane! Blowing up his own bridge and then rebuilding it. That's rather inspirational.
It is vital that the Germans believe the bridge to be destroyed. He must not suspect us.
I need to leave one alive and chase it away?
That plan.
One Nazi plane is reporting the state of the bridge to his superiors.
Excellent. They will think that Tito moves north.
By the time we realize that troops will have covered many unnecessary miles, we will escape ahead of them.
Bombers!
Destroy them all. They cannot be allowed to report the bridge was already destroyed when they arrived.
This is madness. But shoot down bombers. I understand that. Plan I understand. Shoot down the bombers.
More bombers, Didi.
Down.
The third wave of bombers.
The Nazis really wanted that bridge bombed. Too bad they were beaten to it.
What?
I remember when I first saw the ruins of the Nerethva Bridge. Not 2 months since I'd flown solo to protect it. It wasn't even the Nazis who destroyed it in the end. The plan was sheer madness, yet I had to admire the gall of the partisan fighters. With their backs to the river, panzer shells ready to rain down on their heads, they dared to bluff the might of the German army. The explosion shook the town to its foundations, but was it enough to fool the enemy into thinking the partisans were pushing to the north? The Nerethva Gambit illustrated a kind of courage I had never imagined. That bravery seemed to be at the heart of all the resistance forces I fought alongside. Even though their war was already lost, there was no capitulation, no surrender, and no despair. Even Clive seemed strengthened during those days, seeking solace less often in a bottle, and more through his actions, working to improve my chances in the air. To reach the Cochula camp, Tommy. I don't have time to talk, especially to McIntyre.
Observer.
safety.
McIntyre and I, we don't like each other.
Seems reasonable.